Hello. I have opened my shop. I can't believe this is happening. I've been working on this for a very long time. But I'm excited. I guess I'll just show you what I've been working on lately. So we got this guy. It's a cute little duck. He holds your pens or your paintbrushes if you don't want to get paint on anything. He's gonna be for sale in my shop. And I've got this cute little mushroom character. He's got a little cute little booty. It'll focus on that booty. I don't think my camera likes booties. Oh, okay. But he glows in the dark, actually, so that's pretty cool. I glaze these. I have to glaze them still. But I glaze them so that they will last longer and they can handle a beating. And then I have these cute little bird magnets for your fridge or wherever you want to put them on. And it also comes in a magnet form. I made these out of clay. They were so fun to make, but I really hate glazing. It's not that fun. I also made these cute little pigeons. They're pins and magnets as well. I have one with white eyes and I have one with yellow eyes. And I got this cute little blue fish guy. I don't know how well he'll do, but he was fun to make. But after a while, I kind of didn't like painting him. It was a bit tedious getting in between the gaps with a Posca pen. But I really like him. He like his big old eye. He's very cute, I think. So I have a cat. We used to have a cat named Taffy, and I made little pins and magnets of her. I made a blue one, and I also made a black one. I'll show you in a little bit. That's what they look like. Get a better look of them. These will also be in my shop. And here's the black taffy pin and the taffy magnet. Sorry about the glare, that's terrible. And I've got these cute little hamburger guys that I was inspired by the Bee and Puppy Cat to make. This one's a magnet and this one's a pin. I really like the pins. I think they're cute. And I also like the magnets too because I have a whole lot of room on my fridge, so I can hoard as many magnets as I want. And here I didn't make them thick enough, but I've got some corgi pins. I didn't make them thick enough to be a magnet, or at least the ones that I buy, but this is what he looks like. I love him. He's so cute. He was also very tedious to paint, but I like the shape. It was so much fun cutting them out and painting him. Times. I've got these cute little cactus pins. If you're a plant or cactus or succulent lover, they are also men magnets, if interested. Here's one I did for Spirited Away. I liked this one very much. He came out so good. This is No Face. I wanted to kind of make a chibi version of him. He is a pin right now. If these are popular, if you guys want me to make more of these, let me know. And I'll make them and sell them, and you guys can have them. But right now, I just have one, so we'll see how much of you guys like these. I also made one cat holding a fish in his mouth pin. I only did one of these because it was a little. I didn't know how to feel about it, so I wanted to see what my viewers thought of this to see if you guys like it and if you would want these. I'll make more, but right now I just got this one in the works. I also have this strawberry milk. I'm so sorry, it's backwards on the camera, but I got some strawberry milk. Oh no, I dropped it. But at least I know it's durable. But yeah, these are pins and they're also magnets. These are only going to be on my shop for a limited time. I wasn't too happy with the design. I feel like I could have done better. So these are what I have for now. And maybe I'll make more in the future. Maybe not. I'll probably stick to my animals that I like making. I forgot to talk about these guys, but these are cute little miniature otter keychains. These will also be glazed. So yeah, I'd make a cute little chibi version of these. These were so fun to make. I like their little potato shapes. And then also I have these, I don't know if I want to have these be melon bread or maybe Hispanic bread. I have one side of my family who's Hispanic. We're Puerto Rican, so I don't know what type of bread this would be. I need to do my research on what type of foods we have. And I hope to add see these in the future. These are like little marshmallow kitties with chocolate sauce. Let's see if it'll focus, please. Gonna focus for me? Maybe if I move out of the way, I don't know. But these are gonna be available. I'm gonna glaze them and make them stronger. My friend already, I gave her one, so let me know how it did. And she says that I probably need to do a better job super gluing the keychain so it doesn't fall off. So I am going to do better fixing that. I am going to hopefully make some cute little tadpoles. I love frogs and tadpoles. I mean, who doesn't? This one glows in the dark. At least these spots and the little stripe on the tail do. These will be available at some point if you guys want them. I'll try and make more. Let's see here. And then here's my little frog. He's kind of just a little. He's just a little blob. I had fun making him. I think he's cute. And he also has a booty. A lot of my frogs have booties. So, yeah. That's what I got for now for clay stuff. Okay, now for the prints that I have available. I got this cute little frog guy print. I love him so much. It was so fun to make. This will be in my shop. I've got this cute little otter. I painted this traditionally, but I'm gonna make copies and I'll sell the copies. I think for pretty much all of these. So I don't wear myself down so easily. And I have this cute little fuzzy moss snapping turtle. And this is one of my favorite ones. It's a baby panda eating some ramen noodles. This was inspired by Kung Fu Panda, as you can't see. And then I got a cat playing with a caterpillar. I was inspired by my cat, Taffy. I was playing with a butterfly that recently came out of its cocoon, so that was awesome to see. She didn't hurt it, she was just sniffing it. And then I got this one, it's just underwater. I was trying to do semi-realism a little bit, so we'll see how this one does. I'm not so sure. And then we've got this guy. It's a seagull eating some Cheetos. I really like how this one turned out. He was one of my favorite ones to draw. And then we have a pigeon sitting on top of spaghetti and eating it. This is also a favorite of mine. I was trying to find my style. Let's see. I can't remember if I have this one up on my shop, but if you're interested, I will have it up. And this could be yours. I really like the goldfish. I just feel like there's not enough color. I maybe want to redo this at some point. All right. And then another one of my favorites. We have the red panda. And I did Rold? I don't remember his name, but I saw him on Google and I thought he was adorable and I wanted to paint him. I don't think this one's on my shop yet, but if you want him, I will make copies so you guys can have him. I thought he was super cute and you guys would love him. I mean, who couldn't love this face? That's so cute. Him eating his ice cream cone. I thought it'd be just, oh, that'd be the most cutest thing. And then I got some plants. I don't know what type of plant this is. I saw it on Google. And so I thought I'd simplify it. And then another one. Maybe this could be a monstera. I'm not sure. But yeah, this is one of them. And then we got a ice cream turtle. And we have koi fish. This one I struggled with. I haven't drawn fish that much, like from above view, but I like how it came out. It's okay for a first time. And then I have my chickens and her little chicks. I feel like this is giving me fall vibes, the colors. I don't know. And then I originally did this one for my husband's birthday. But I thought you guys would like it too if I made prints of these and maybe turn it into a sticker. I don't know. I think he would be a good sticker. I liked how he came out. It was inspired by Digimon. I watched that as a kid a lot. And then we have a ring-tailed cat. I didn't know they lived in Texas and North America. Like, the things I don't know of what creatures are beyond my state. I need to get out more. But I like this one. This one was like very, I struggled a little bit. I had to keep tweaking things and fixing things because I would mess up. But I'm happy. And then this one I mainly did with markers. It's a little panda eating some bamboo. I really like it. And everyone's gonna go crazy for this one. It is some whale sharks. It was like my first video on TikTok to blow up a little bit. Or at least to have my first thousands of views within like an hour. Like, no joke. So I was like, okay, a lot of people seem to like whale sharks and I liked them too after drawing this. And maybe I'll make some whale shark stickers. I've got some lovebird prints. Maybe this would be a good gift for like Valentine's Day or a card maybe. And then we got my capybara one with some peaches. This one's one of my favorites too. I like the colors. And my other favorite I did. This is a dog carrying a pink ball in his mouth and just running through the woods, having a good time. I think it was my first time I could smell the gouache. Yes, I used gouache. It was the beginning of this year that I painted this and I could not remember what all you used, but I was using gouache for the first times and I liked it. And I like the textures that I got in the grass and stuff. I really want to do more like this again because I really enjoyed it. Okay. And then my first ever print that I had made this year is this duck. I liked it for a first try. I feel like I could do better, but I like the colors and the green and the pink and the white and the blue. I think they look really good. But yeah, these will be available. All these prints you see will be available in my shop, and if they're not on there yet, then I will add them soon. All right, and we got some stickers. I have a husky with corn. These are water resistant. They are not waterproof. These are available. This guy's available. I forgot what this is called. Taiyaki ice cream with matcha ice cream. It came out a little dark when I printed it, but then when I tried the other settings, it came out too light or too dark. I could never find it in between, so I don't know. Maybe I just gotta keep working at it. And then we have the big brain thinky sticker. It's a brain and it's on overdrive. It smokes coming out of its brain and some electricity. I made this originally into a print for my husband because he is a big thinker. He is a math whiz and he sometimes does not want to be bothered. I'm sure you guys can relate when you don't want to be bothered. So I made him a little print saying Big Brain Thinky because that's why I'll know when not to disturb him. And then we got this cute little chicken. If it'll focus, please. Focus for me. No. Huh. Okay, maybe if I leave. Will you focus? For some reason, my camera's not wanting to focus, but we have a brown one and we have a white one. This was inspired by Nubs, who is a little rooster who only has nubs, like his feet are underdeveloped. I don't know if he was born that way or he had an accident, but he wears boots. You gotta look him up. He's on TikTok. He's very cute. And then we have my little Pomeranian Chihuahua dog with Christmas lights. I'm really hating my camera right now. It's not wanting to focus for me. It's normally good at focusing, but for some reason, when I want to make a video, it hates me. Okay. We'll try our best here. And I did another one of my dog, Foxy. This is her. She's very old, that's why I made her eyes kind of like, sleepy. And then I have a. So you remember that the print I made of the ice cream turtle? This is him with his tongue out. So I thought it'd be very cute to have him like this. All right, and then this is a little dark. They didn't come out as light as I wanted them to be, but it's a capybara taking a bath with some fruit, inspired by Spirited Away with all the ducks taking a bath in the tub. And I have a little chibi pug sticker. These are some of my older stickers. And then I have a tiny, tiny axolotl sticker. A lot of these stickers are tiny compared to the ones I just showed you. But yeah, these are water resistant stickers. I have them on my water bottle and they'll take a good couple of spills. But I wouldn't necessarily put them in the washing machine or the dishwasher. And one time my bottle was like sitting in water, and you can tell that this one got faded pretty bad. This one took a good amount of water and it faded a little bit. You can see it bled outwards, but the rest of them are good. But if they're sitting in water for too long, then yeah, that's what happens. A lot of stickers, so I don't know if I'll be able to show all of them, but I'll show the ones that I think you guys will like. We have a cute little goldfish with a dumpling on his head. And I was inspired by Uncomfy Co. She has a goldfish. She does clay sculptures. And I like what she does, so I was like, oh, I want to make a sticker into my style. So I did that. I like how she does goldfish sculptures. They're so cute and chubby. And we've got some frog stickers. I know that you guys have been waiting for that. There's one of them sitting. Let's see if I can get them out. They're in this little drawer. And then this one's on his back relaxing. I like that one. This one's with the strawberry. This one is tooting. And it's just a frog butt. And we've got another one sitting. And he's got his cute little nubby hands there. And then I have a frog stack. And I have this one that's just on his belly. Let's see, what other ones do I have that I think you guys will like? I've got a bird one that I did of my clay pens. I decided to make them into stickers because they were, I think I was sick and I wanted to do something simple to get back into doing digital art. And I've got this one that's a black taffy sticker. And I've got this one that's in blue. And this one that's a cactus. Okay, and now for my favorite stickers, I've got this axolotl drinking some strawberry milk. Man, I really hate my camera. It's not working the way I want it to. And then we got this cute squishy rain frog and a little forest sticker, this cute narwhal sticker, a raccoon eating a slice of pizza, one of my favorites, and a corgi butt sticker, one of the first stickers I made, ice cream cookie cat. I made this one after my cat Taffy passed away, I remember, and I was needing to do some art therapy, and this is what I made in that time of sadness. Another one of my favorites. It is a grumpy little rain frog, or desert rain frog, with some dumplings on his head in a basket. I really like this one. This one's so cute, and I love his cute little chubby body. I have these mushroom stickers, and then I have this stingray sticker, that one that was on my water bottle that got messed up from water. And I have this cat bread loaf sticker. Man, it's really hard to see on camera. You could see it better on my shop. I apologize again for bad quality. And then these were inspired by my pets and also me and puppy cat. I've got this one eating soup because one time my cat actually put her paw in to my soup and shook the soup everywhere. And then I have this one. This also happened. My cat started eating my cereal. So these were both inspired by being puppy cat. I like the little cat style. I wanted to try it. So really happy how these turned out. I hope you guys like them. I have another cat named Lily, and this is one of her. She's kind of a little grumpy cat. She's a ragamuffin. Oh, I forgot to show you my ragamuffin sticker, or my snuggle muffin cat sticker. This is also Lily having a muffin on her head. But yeah, I made one of her in a chef costume, and I made one her in, with a muffin. Okay, last ones that I'm gonna show because this is very, very long. So we've got, these are seals, and it's ice cream. They're ice cream. And they're stacked up onto each other in ice cream cone. I like these. And then we've got my other frog sticker. I wanted to do a different style. I think I made this one first before I made that other one. I don't remember. But I like this one. And he's also got a basket full of dumplings on his back. But yeah, that's all my stickers for now. The rest are on my shop if I missed any. You guys can go check that out. The link will be in the description below and also in my bio. Yeah, thank you for your time. I appreciate you guys for watching. And I guess I'll continue to maybe film my journey with my art business. And we'll see how this goes. Yeah. Bye, guys. Take care.